Let's think about what's inside the CFD black box and what it tells us about how to verify and validate results. And this framework, some of you might have already come across from my other modules because I use it across various disciplines, whether it's solid mechanics, fluid mechanics, or heat transfer. And it's really helpful to think through what's under the hood. For instance, I had a student who did a summer internship at NASA. He said he was doing CFD simulations there. And he said people were impressed that he not only was able to do the CFD simulations, but he was able to describe what's happening under the hood. And that was, you know, very pleasant for me to hear. And I had a smile on my face for the rest of the day. So this is, you know, this is a robust general framework to think about simulations even beyond CFD. Okay, so we have our black box, and we'll give it user inputs, and we'll get color pictures or other results. And we will pick the user inputs, geometry, mesh, boundary conditions, material properties, based on the physical problem we have, the experiment that students do in the Cornell course. But the most important thing to keep in mind is that the black box is not solving the physical problem. It's solving a mathematical model of the physical problem that's based on differential equations and with boundary conditions. And that mathematical model is built from the physical problem based on physical principles and assumptions. So the most important thing we want to know is, what is a mathematical model? What are the governing equations and boundary conditions? And what are the physical principles and assumptions built into that mathematical model? And then the tool, Fluent in our case, will do a numerical solution to that mathematical model by converting differential equations to algebraic equations, and we'll see that in a little bit. And it'll get selected variables at selected points. So it won't get all variables at all points, it'll get only selected variables at selected points. So we need to know what the selected variables are, and what those selected points are, which we'll mark out through the mesh. And everything else is constructed from those selected variables at selected points through post-processing. And one can also go back to the physical problem and make hand calculations. Maybe you can approximate this mathematical model. In this case, you can, and, you know, do scaling arguments, which textbooks do for heated flow in a pipe. So one can do hand calculations. But when one does that, one needs to know, you know, situated against what the tool is doing, whether it's using the same mathematical model, it's using the different mathematical model, and so on. And in this case, we also have experimental data that we can compare to. And so this is a, you know, this framework is a good way to organize all these various pieces of information that we have. And so... You know, from this framework, then we can figure out what we need to do for verification validation, and in fact, what is the difference between the two, okay? So let's think about the definition of verification validation, which I found very pleasantly falls out of this framework very nicely, elegantly. So verification is, did I solve the model right? That is, whatever mathematical model I picked, did I solve it right? Did I input the right mathematical model into the tool? Are the results consistent? Are my results consistent with the mathematical model? What are the level of numerical errors that the tool introduces? You know, and the hand calculations, what kind of comparison between hand calculations and the simulation results do I see? So all these are looking at how, you know, whether you solved your particular mathematical model correctly. Okay, so it's looking at kind of what's happening over here. In contrast, validation is asking the question, did I solve the right model? So contrast that to this. So whatever mathematical model I picked, is that a reasonable representation of the physics for my particular purpose? Are the physical principles valid? Are the assumptions reasonable? And here, to do, you know, so to check the validity of the mathematical model, versus the physical problem, typically one needs X mental data, which we have. So that's how we will do the verification and validation. Okay, so that gives you an idea of what verification validation is. And you build up to that by doing a pre-analysis. So this is an analysis before you get into the tool. And then I'll indicate, as you know, once we get to doing the verification validation, how that pre-analysis builds into verification validation. So next, let's do the pre-analysis.